Greetings, recruits, and welcome to the distant future of Warhammer 40K. If you clicked on this video, you're probably either curious about 40K or the owner of a Recruit Edition box. Well, for whatever reason you clicked, this video aims to answer your questions about how to start 40K. A little about 40K for the uninitiated. Warhammer 40K is a sci-fi fantasy game that takes place in the year 40,000. Humanity has colonized the stars and is besieged on all sides by aliens and monsters. Only the Emperor, the most powerful human ever, and his armies are able to keep the darkness at bay, and the greatest of these armies are his Space Marines. In 40K, there are many armies such as Super Soldiers, Savage Orcs, Ancient Aliens, Creatures of Nightmares, and many more. These factions vie for control of the galaxy. This merely scratches the surface of the lore and setting of 40K, but should help to orient new players. Just remember that in the grim darkness of the far future, there is only war. Now to the actual contents of the box. The Recruit Edition comes with two armies, Space Marines and Necrons. The Space Marine army is made up of 5 Assault Intercessors, the close combat shock troops of the Adeptus Astartes, and are led by a heroic Primaris Lieutenant with Storm Shield and Power Sword. The Necrons include 10 durable warriors, 3 Scarab Swarms, and are led by an indomitable Royal Warden armed with a Relic Goss Blaster. Besides the models, this box also comes with a small rulebook, measuring tools, dice, a playmat, everything that you need to start playing. If you are wondering if this box is a good way to get into the hobby, it is. $50 for everything in the box makes it sit very appealing, especially if you split the content and the price with a friend. The rest of the video will focus on how to assemble the models found in this box and some basic tips and tricks. In order to assemble the contents of this box, you'll need a hobby knife and a pair of hobby snips. Glue is not required as they are pushed to fit models. So let's get started. The first thing you're going to want to do is take your hobby snips and get them as close to the piece that you're cutting out. Don't get it as too close as you can cut into the plastic. Be especially careful with that bottom peg as that's what will stick into the base. When you're done cutting out the piece that you want to work with, take your hobby knife and slowly and carefully cut away the remaining sprue tab. When you're done with the piece, put it into a small container to keep it away from the other pieces. So here's a closer view of what I'm doing with the sprue tabs. I carefully take my hobby knife and slowly cut away the excess plastic from the sprue tab. It's helpful if your knife is really sharp when you do this, as it makes it way easier to cut away the sprue tabs. Just be slow and methodical when you do this, and you won't damage any of the details. Another thing you'll want to do when preparing your models is remove any mold lines. To do this, drag your hobby knife gently against any lines you see. If you do it softly, you won't damage any of the details. You'll want to do this because it'll pay dividends later when you paint them. On Space Marines, they tend to have prominent lines on helmets, legs, and on power packs. Just be patient and make sure that you don't miss any lines that can be easily reached or seen on the model. Once you have all of the pieces prepared, you'll then move on to assembly. For this model, you'll first attach the chainsword to the sergeant's waist. You'll then take the other half and push it all together. Make sure that it is tight, as the sword will fall off if they aren't. You'll then take the head and put it into the notch. You'll then take the breastplate and push the two halves together. Take great care as this step is very finicky and it's easy to drop the head. Once you have the two halves together, you'll attach the arms. It doesn't matter how you do it. Just make sure that the pins go in. They only go together one way, but there's a little bit of give between each position. Once you have the arms attached, you can start to attach it to the base. Simply take the peg out the bottom of the foot and slip it into the base. Remember to attach the power pack like I forgot to do, and then you'll have yourself a complete assault intercessor. Assemble the other four in the same manner. We'll next start assembling the Royal Warden. Cutting out the pieces is exactly the same as for the Space Marines, but his sarcophagus cloak can be very fragile, so be careful when clipping it out. Like with the Space Marine, you'll then take your hobby knife and cut away the sprue tabs very carefully. The only other piece I have something interesting to say about is the left arm. Make sure not to clip away the tab that inserts into the gun, but make sure that it'll fit inside the slot. Once you have all of the pieces clipped, you'll move on to assembly. You'll first need the shoulders and the spine. Put the rod into the hole. As you can see, it didn't fit the first time, so I trimmed away the excess until it did. You'll then take the arms and attach them to the torso. They all have little notches that they fit into. You'll then take the shoulder blades and slip them in. Next, take the breastplate and put it into place. Make sure that it is facing upwards when you do it. Lastly, take the head and put it into place. And just like that, you have yourselves a Necron Royal Warden. What we'll be building next are the Scarab Swarms, which are some of the easiest models I have ever built. Simply cut them out of the sprues and clean up the sprue tabs. Be careful near their legs, as they are very fragile. Simply stick them onto a base and call it done. It really is that simple to build these Scarab models. For the two Scarab Swarms with rocks, put the skinny peg in first and then line up the fat one with the other hole and push. And just like that, you have three Scarab Swarms. Next, we'll be building the Necron Warrior models. This is done in exactly the same manner as all the other models we've been building. Simply find all of the pieces you want on the sprue using the instructions and clip them and clean them. I've decided to arm all of my guys with Gauss Flayers, as they pack more of a long-range punch, but the Reapers are also good. I would suggest to give all of your guys the same weapons to keep the loadout simple. Once you have all of the pieces clipped, take the two arms and put them together. Next, take the torso and put the arms into the little sockets. You'll then take the breastplate and push it into place. Make sure that the little hole is at the top, because that's where the head goes. Once that's tight, you'll then take the head and push it into the little socket. Do that 9 more times, and you'll have yourself 10 Necron Warriors. And here's everything together. The Royal Warden, the 3 Scarab Swarms, and the 10 Necron Warriors on the left. And on the right, the Primaris Lieutenant, and the 5 Assault Intercessors. As you can see, I painted the Primaris Lieutenant in the colors of the Black Templars as a test model. Thank you for watching my first video. My next video will be about how to paint your first miniature using simple techniques. Please, in the comments, leave suggestions on what you think I can improve on, as I am still very new to this. A like and subscribe would be very much appreciated at this early stage, if you're feeling up to it. Thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoyed this video on Warhammer 40K.